Hello everyone, you are welcome to Best Notes Tutorials. In this video, I will be talking about the age of Dr. Johnson. जैसा कि आप लोग जानते हैं, we are doing history of English literature. हम अभी history of English literature complete कर रहे हैं और इसमें हम 18th century तक videos cover कर चुके हैं in 26 videos. और hopefully आप लोगों को ये series पसंद आ रही होगी. In previous video, I talked about the age of Dr. Johnson. पिछली जो वीडियो थी उसमें मैंने age of Dr. Johnson के बारे में बात की थी. मैंने आपको बताया था कि ये age of transition भी इसे कहा जाता है. And we talked about social condition of the age. Later, we talked about the Augustan poets. This is the Dr. Johnson. This age is also called 18th century and the Augustan age. And we will be talking about some important writers of the age. So first is Dr. Samuel Johnson. And he was born in 1709 and died in 1784. 1738, he published his poem called London. Smollett called him the great champ of literature. Great champ of literature. He worked for Keeves magazine. So remember this. Dr. Johnson worked for Keeves magazine. Next is his dictionary came in 1747 to in between 55 and Vanity of Human Wishes in 1749. Erin in 1749. If you are interested in this PDF, you can get it from comment box. Links are in comment box. You can download it from there. The periodicals he worked with are the Rambler. Two other series, the Adventurer and the Idler, he worked. Rasselas. Rasselas is a didactic tale which got published in 1759. The lives of the most eminent English poets with critical observation on their works. This is his most important work which got published and which was written in between 71 to 81. Some important notes on his poetry. His two poems, London and Vanity of Human Wishes, belong to the neoclassical school of poetry. Why we call it neoclassical school of poetry? Hum neoclassical school of poetry kaise kehte hain? Classical, iske liye sabse pehle hume samajhna padega ki classical word ko classics ya classist unko kaha jata hai jo rules bahut zyada follow karte hain kisi piece of writing ke liye, kisi poem ko likhne ke liye. तो उन्हें हम क्लासिक्स बोलते हैं, क्लासिस्ट बोलते हैं, जो क्लासिक्स को फॉलो करते हैं. और क्लासिस्ट का उल्टा होता है रोमांटिसिस्ट, रोमांटिक पर्सन. सो रोमांटिक्स आर दोज हु डोंट फॉलो टू मेनी रूल्स. दे आर नॉट रूल बम्ड. दे जस्ट राइट देयर हार्ट. उनके हार्ट में जो होगा वो उसको लिख लेंगे फ्रीली. एंड दे कंसिडर दैट बेस्ट पोइट्री. क्लासिस्ट बेस्ट पोइट्री किसे कहते हैं? कि वो रूल बम्प्ड, ज़्यादा रूल्स जिसमें हो, कि अपने जो पुराने जितने राइटर्स हैं उनको फॉलो करते हैं बेटर राइटिंग के लिए. द पोएम वर फुल ऑफ हेरोइक कपलेट. सो रिमेंबर दिस, ही यूज्ड हेरोइक कपलेट एंड पर्सोनिफिकेशन. वैनिटी ऑफ ह्यूमन विशेस इज written in imitation of the 10th satire of Juvenile. So Juvenile का जो 10th satire है उसको उन्होंने imitate किया और Vanity of Human Wishes लिखा. Next writer is Churchill. His best work is the Rosciad, modeled on the Dunciad. So Rosciad जो था वो Dunciad पे modeled है and he was a satirist. And Rosciad is a satire on chief social and political figure of that time. Dunciad bhi satire hai, jo ki डन्स बैड पॉइंट्स पे लिखा गया था. नाउ लेट्स गो टू द नेक्स्ट वन. एमिनेंट पोइट्स ऑफ द ट्रांजिशनल पीरियड. James Thomson, he lived between 1700 to 48, means 1748. And let me suggest you one thing, whenever you are studying these years, काफ़ी मुश्किल होती है, बहुत सारे years होते हैं याद करना, तो उन्हें आप simply इस तरह से याद कीजिए, 48, okay, 47, 35 to 36, तो 35, 36, ये आपको एक तरह से याद रहेगा. बट आप जब इस तरह से याद करते हैं 1735, 1736, सो इट बिकम्स रियली टफ टू रिमेम्बर. तो आप इसे सिंपली इस तरह से याद कर सकते हैं कि जैसे आप 17th century को पढ़ रहे हैं, तो आप पूरे 17th century के 35, 45 कौन सा कब पब्लिश हुआ, इस तरह से आप सिंपली याद कर सकते हैं. ट्राई करके देखिए, ये आपको ईजी लगेगा. A long poem, blank verse, Liberty. Liberty is written in blank verse and it is a quite long poem. And he is the first to bring the few new notes to his poetry. And his first work is the work Season, written in blank verse. So he used blank verse. The Castle of Indolence. Castle of Indolence is written in 1748 and it was written in Spenserian stanza. First, now let's go through the Thomas Gray. Thomas Gray's life is, or his works are divided into three parts. So first period of his writing is here. Let me zoom it here. First period, Hymn to Adversity, Ode to Spring, On the Distant Prospect of Eton College. These are his classic works. The second one, the second period of his writing is the Elegy, written in a country churchyard in 1751. He use of nature, you can see here, use of nature is used by romantics. Jab bhi hum nature ki baat karte hain to romantics ne ise use kiya. And third one is the third period of his life is romantic interest and the Fatal Sisters, he wrote the Descent of the Odin. Now let's talk about Oliver Goldsmith. His first poem was The Traveller and it got published in 1764. Heroic couplet he used, and he wrote about the places he traveled. So the first poem, The Traveller, so he wrote the account of his traveling, ki unhone apne jahan jahan unhone travel kiya uske bare mein unhone likha. The Hermit is his another poem. Elegy on the Death of Mad Dog. And the last one is Deserted Village, 1770. William Collins wrote some odes are there to simplicity, to fear, to simplicity, to fear, to the passion, or ode to evening. First work, Oriental Ecologues in 1742. Mechanical couplet plus romantic feeling. So you can see the romantic feeling and mechanical couplets there. William Collins, the writer. And on Thomson, he wrote, In Yonder Grave Our Druid Lies. यहाँ पे हमने अभी थॉमसन के बारे में पढ़ा था. सो ऑन थॉमसन ही रोट इन योंडर ग्रेव अ ड्रूड लाइज, हाउ स्लीप अ ब्रेव. his elegies are here. So these are his two elegies. So hopefully you like the video till here. In next video, we will be talking about the new school and the age of Dr. Johnson.